And welcome in to another season of Freed-Hardeman University Athletics. We kick our year off with volleyball. Ray Pack and Michael Mullenix here to bring you this game as the Pioneers from Crowley's Ridge in Arkansas have come to town. Go ahead and mention this. They'll take on your Lady Lions. Also after this match, Crowley's Ridge will take on Lane College. And that'll follow probably 30 to 45 minutes after this one. Give them time to get warmed up. And then after that match, then the Dragons from Lane College, they will take on your Freed-Hardeman University Lady Lions. Michael, it's been a while. How are you, brother?
I'm doing great, Coach. Doing great.
You ready to go?
I'm ready to go, ready to be back in action here at Freed-Hardeman. It's been a while, probably since May, I believe, was the last time we did a Freed-Hardeman game.
The last time that I did was in the booth for Freed-Hardeman was the final game of softball season. I know I came up to visit you and Coach Joe up in baseball. And he was gracious enough to let me on the air a couple of times, but glad that we were able to do that. And remind everybody, with athletics, we'll be doing volleyball. There'll be some of them that we won't do, but Friday nights are reserved for high school football. I know Paul and his group will be broadcasting Peabody High School football, Golden Tide. I'll be doing Chester County High School, so that ties up our Friday nights, but we're going to try to bring you all the other games that don't have a conflict there with that. And then basketball season will crank up.
That's right. Starts in November, I believe. I know the girls kick off with Austin Peay.
Yeah, they go to the girls' basketball, travels up to Austin Peay for the exhibition game. But the action for the girls actually starts, I think it's November 6th. And we'll have a triple header that day. We'll do volleyball. And I want to turn this off so it doesn't distract us. But we'll have volleyball at like 10 in the morning.
Believe so, yes, sir.
And then you'll have men's basketball, women's women's basketball, then followed by men's basketball. And as you think about that day, that's going to be a long day.
It is.
I'll be doing the volleyball, and then I'll be down at the scorer's table for the basketball game. So, hey, let's talk about this a little bit here. Freed-Hardeman comes in at 1-3. They went down to Faulkner and played in a tournament there. And ended up going to 1-3. Crowley's Ridge comes in at 1-2. And I talked to both coaches. Carissa Wynn, Crowley's Ridge is coached by Carissa Wynn, who was a 2011 graduate here at Freed-Hardeman. And I went down to ask her, so what offense are you going to run? And she kind of hesitated. She said, but I guess we'll run a 5-1, which will be the same as what Freed-Hardeman runs. And for those who don't understand what that means, it means you have five players that will be able to attack the ball. And one primary setter on Freed-Hardeman, that'll be Allie Humphrey. As Claire Walker is going to set us off in this first serve of our home season for Lady Lion Volleyball.
And another thing we want to mention about Casey Donegan, 7 kills away from 1,000 kills.
There's the set. There's the attack. Just a little dink over. Allie sets it. Donegan, guess what? Now she's 6 away. And those who didn't hear that, seven kills away from 1,000 in her career for Casey Donegan. She came in as a freshman on fire for the Lady Lions and served two back to the number 5 serving slot. Number 3 there, Jaden Hesse sets it up. It's going to be Emma Campbell gets it to Donegan again, and 2 sets, 2 kills. It's a pretty good attack percentage.
And Casey Donegan, the junior from Dixon, Tennessee, and, of course, looking at the new Freed-Hardeman website that was just recently launched.
Oh, how nice it is.
It is really good. Been looking at that here a lot lately.
There's an out-of-bounds. So, almost said Chester County Freed-Hardeman jumping out 3-0 here quick. You look at these statistics. Donegan comes in averaging 3.21 kills per match. Nice dig there by Emma Campbell. Across to the backside to Ashlyn Cliff, and she hits a little strong and out of bounds as Katie Speaks is going to check in as a defensive specialist for Claire Walker. Back to serve for the Lady Pioneers is Brooklyn Passmore. And there's the set to the middle. And that time Avery Harris, she's a freshman middle blocker from Lebanon, Tennessee, just a tad outside. You come back, you know, you got to rotate your offense, but you come back to your beast there on the front line, and Casey Dunnigan, that's three. So four more, and she's at that 1,000 mark.
Not taking her long at all, and she's almost one past her average.
And that ball called out as it hit the antenna. We've got Harris back serving for Freed-Hardeman. And there's a tip. Oh, nice up by Dunnigan with the over ball. And there's another, just a tip. I don't know if they're doing that intentionally or not. And there's a kill in the middle for Annalise Jackson. We called her name a lot, from Pegram, Tennessee.
I believe a graduate from Harpeth High School, if I'm not mistaken.
I believe that's correct. We don't have that on here this year. And there's going to be – that's going to be a kill by number 10, Paige Glenn, as it went off of the hands that time of Annalise Jackson. Now serving will be the libero, number 5, Caitlin Perkins. Short serve. Dunnigan puts the ball over the net, set back to the middle. And there's a block by Annalise Jackson.
And Annalise Jackson, if you remember going back to last season, the last few games we did – had a great game against Shawnee State. I believe was up near the double digits,
yes,
in the blocks category,
yes,
if not in double digits.
As Ashlyn Cliff on a roll shot. She's going to set it up for Dunnigan. Dunnigan off the net a little bit, but guess what? That counts as a kill, so that makes five on the day, right?
I believe so. Or no, that's four, I believe. Or it might be four away. Boom.
Taylor's waving at us from across the floor. He's going to keep us updated in case we miss one. There's Cliff's serve. Deep. Nice serve. Sets it up outside. And taking it out of bounds is Emmy Elms. So Freed-Hardeman up 9-3 here in set number one. That time, a little serve right off the net. There's the six back set to the opposite side hitter. Humphrey coming to Dunnigan. And that time, Dunnigan, she had to go over the block and just didn't get the tip, and it goes out of bounds. As Bryce Morris comes in for Freed-Hardeman. Try to get you subs at least once so we get all these young ladies' names called. Morris, a defensive specialist from right here in Henderson, Tennessee. Nice job by Speaks. An overball by Dunnigan. Going to go to the outside hitter. Morris with a nice up. And Humphrey going to be called for a double hit. You pretty well tell that. I don't. You may have forgotten, but I talked with you about it last year. You generally tell a double hit when the ball changes directions. And a service error there by Olivia Deckelman for the Pioneers. So Dunnigan now moves to the back row as Claire Walker, Freed-Hardeman. That's the fantastic duo of hitters right there for Freed-Hardeman. And Humphrey sends it deep. And
that was a good play there by Humphrey.
It was. You know, you do that to keep your defense honest. She put it way back in the number five spot in the corner, which forced the error by the setter. And
just out, I believe.
Looked like Hannah Halverson tried to go the opposite side, and it was just out. Done again with another serve. Going to go to the outside hitter. Blocked back. And try the back row attack there by Brooklyn Passmore as the set was back to her, but it didn't go anywhere.
And think about this Crowley's Ridge team, only two seniors this year,
yeah,
for them.
Yeah, I noticed that.
Of course, Deckelman and then their libero, Caitlin Perkins.
As that time, I don't think Annalise hit the ball, but it was short. And if it would, come over, she was right there. And there's a service ace for Dunnigan.
Passmore barely had any time to react right there.
15-5 here in set number one. Oh, nice little short serve. And there's Annalise. There she is, Jackson, again with the that kill. And I believe Crowley Ridge is going to take a timeout. We'll take a quick one with them. It's 16-5, Freed-Hardeman. We'll be right back on the FHU Sports Network.
Buying a car is all about you. In person, over the phone, or online, we make it simple and easy. Our place is yours, no matter where you live. LonnieCobbFord.com or Lonnie Cobb Ford in Henderson, where cars really are cheaper in the country. At Lonnie Cobb Ford, we now give you a warranty for life on engine and transmission. That's right, a warranty for life at no cost to you. Unlimited time, unlimited mileage, but it's only at Lonnie Cobb Ford in Henderson, where cars really are cheaper in the country.
With extra pandemic unemployment funding.
Welcome back in as we get ready to come back out as the timeout clock didn't start, but both teams are back on the floor as Dunnigan will resume serving for the Lady Lions.
And, of course, Dunnigan, I believe Taylor confirmed it a minute ago, four kills away from 1,000.
And there's the kill by Emmy Elms. She's a 6-foot sophomore right there from Paragould. She went to Crowley's Ridge Academy. You know, they've got a high school and a college there.
That's right. And we did have a sub a minute ago.
Did I miss it?
It's going to be number one, Charlie Fulton. And what people might not know, of course, remember the last name Fulton, is the little sister of Riley Fulton.
And wearing the same number as her sister, and there she is with the set. Humphrey's going to push it over. And Brooklyn Passmore with the kill there for Crowley's Ridge. So after the timeout, Crowley's Ridge has on a 2-0 run.
That's right. And that was a good hustle there by Morris, but just a little bit out of the reach right there.
And Claire Walker goes long. That set gets a little bit too far off the net. Then you got to adjust, and kind of a tough thing right there. And that time Walker just, you know, she adjusted and she just kind of rolled that one over instead of trying to smash it down.
Just perfect placement there by Walker, who is coming back for that COVID year.
She's in her fifth year as a senior, came back, took advantage of that. As Campbell with the serve, the back set, Fulton right there, and Walker with another kill. So Crowley's Ridge comes out, runs three straight. Now Freed-Hardeman is up, now back up by 10, 18-8.
And I believe it is first one to 25.
25.
In the first.
First four first sets four. Are 25. If you go to a fifth, it's the first one to 15. And that time, I think Crowley's Ridge is looking and they see the hard kill is not going to be there. They're going to have to use the little touched kills.
And see the libero, Caitlin Perkins went out, but I wasn't looking who came in for.
I don't know, but there was a nice kill by Avery Harris. I think number six probably subbed in.
If that's correct, that is Hannah Halverson, the sophomore outside hitter.
And there's a free ball for Crowley's Ridge, and blocked back. There's an over ball. And that time, the over there kind of created a little trouble for Freed-Hardeman's defense. 19-10. broadcast today, produced, directed by Paul Schultze.
And also camera operator.
And one camera operator. We got one on the floor. There's another kill by Freed-Hardeman. And what's the young lady's name on the floor, Paul?
Mary Bannister.
And Mary Bannister, she's running the camera down on the floor. You see those great shots down on the floor. She's down there. And there's a quick pop by the setter from Crowley's Ridge, and there is Ashlyn Cliff, a junior from Southside High School in Jackson.
That's right.
And we talked about this last year. You've got four or five kids that are on this team, and in high school they were arch rivals, and now they're teammates.
That's right. And you're seeing that a lot lately now. Of course, with this one you have players from – you get that real quick.
Have nice block right there by the freshman, Avery Harris.
And, of course, you got players from who went to Chester County, then you had Southside. I believe we have a couple from Lexington.
You got Lexington. Walker going to set up now. Dunnigan. I think that's three. Two?
Two more,
she needs two more to hit 1,000.
I would say you try to do this right here. It's Claire serving. And hits the outside hitter. Walker with a nice up. There it is. Now she needs one. Yeah, you feed the beast. I mean, you feed who, you know, you just keep feeding. So she's got six kills here in the first set for Casey Dunnigan. Humphrey out as the setter. That time now she has to hit. Sets out to the outside hitter, Passmore. Up by Campbell, going to go to Walker on the back row. Walker, just rolled it a little bit long that time. She didn't quite get her arm above her head. She got just a little bit back, or her hand was back. So Passmore serving for Crowley's Ridge. Oh, nice little. Dunnigan saw the block and went to the roll. Humphrey. Now Campbell. Dunnigan blocked back. Nice up by Harris. And Ashlyn Cliff puts it down. So Freed-Hardeman takes set number one, 25-11. And that leaves Casey Dunnigan one kill away from 1,000. We'll be back after these messages on the FHU Sports Network.
With extra pandemic unemployment funding coming to an end in Tennessee, you should not hesitate to find a job that pays what you need and treats you well, because those jobs are going to go as quickly as gasoline in a shortage. Apply today at McLean Power Systems in Trenton. This is what their workers had to say.
I like the atmosphere of the department I work in the warehouse, and I like my leadership team with the managing supervisor.
I actually like that you are able to grow within the company. I started here as an operator in the sales, and I've been able to work my way up to a supervisor.
Honestly, it's every person I've kind of interacted with here. I've enjoyed every one of them.
I've been with McLean almost 2 years now, and I will have to say, not only with the great pay and benefits, leadership is absolutely wonderful.
Make your next career move to McLean today by texting POWER to 67664. That's POWER to 67664. McLean Power Systems is an equal opportunity employer.
Football looks fun. I bet I would have been great at it. The first football playing Deer, they would have made a movie about me and everything. Probably get Kurt Russell to play me. But alas, me and my dreams run right over again.
For fast, reliable collision repair, trust the experts at Mitchell's Body Shop. And get back out there.
Men, there's a new salon in Jackson, Race Clips, on South Highland, next door to Roland Safety and Supply. Whether it's a quick trim or a new look, Race Clips stylists can transform you to perfection. At Race Clips, you'll find all the products to keep you looking your best. Active duty military, veterans, and law enforcement officers receive a discount. Open Monday through Friday from 9 to 6, 9 to 3 on Saturday. Race Clips on South Highland, Jackson. Go to race-clips.com.
27 years ago, a vision became a reality and Snookum Steakhouse officially opened. We cut our steaks in-house and our ribeyes are full of flavor. The steak trimmings are used to make our certified Angus beef steak burgers, so when you order at Snookums, you are getting high quality. Enjoy our salad bar and mini dessert. Also try our famous family recipe, the Pink Lush Fruit Salad. Come visit Snookums Steakhouse in Henderson, Tennessee. We are open evenings Tuesday through Saturday, but closed Sunday and Monday. Snookums Steakhouse, come taste the difference.
And welcome back as we get ready to go to set number two. Appreciate Mr. Jeremy Wright coming up. He brings us our stats. Crowley's Ridge. Hitting percentage of minus .059, and Freed-Hardeman hitting at 321. Of course, they're led by in kills by Casey Dunnigan with six.
Got six out of the 14, close to the 50% mark right there. So great showing by Casey Dunnigan. Just needs one more right here.
Yeah, but you're going to – I tell you what, I'm impressed right now with Freed-Hardeman, these freshmen coming in. Avery Harris, the freshman from Lebanon. You know, you always wonder what your freshmen are going to do, if they're going to be able to contribute. And there's an over ball. She goes back and gets it. Now, Dunnigan. Block straight up. And I bet Humphrey comes right back to her. And that, folks, is kill number 1,000 for Casey Dunnigan in her career. And she's just a junior.
Just a junior. And I believe, can't remember what Riley Fulton was at. Riley
was more the defensive specialist, so she was more worried about Diggs.
She
had the digs. As had a touch there. That's 3-0 for Freed-Hardeman here at set two. There's a deep serve. Freed's going deep with the serves today.
They are.
And you're going to have a.
I believe they got a net violation on Annalise Jackson. And here's the serve. And good dig there by number 24, Emma Campbell. And they're going to get Freed-Hardeman with another violation right there. And brings the score 3-2 Freed-Hardeman here in the second set. Crowley's Ridge, number 2, Brooklyn Passmore, will be back serving on this one. Good dig there by Dunnigan. And good there by number 7, Ashlyn Clift. And number 4, Olivia Deckelman, just able to put that perfect placement and ties this set up here in the second, 3-3. And Passmore will be back again. Freed-Hardeman leads 1-0, one set to 0. And Passmore just hits that right off the net, right where the Freed-Hardeman defenders unfortunately were not. Brings the score 4-3, Crowley's Ridge. And Freed-Hardeman going to be looking to stop that run here by Crowley's Ridge. And that one just out of bounds there. Good eye there by the back row there for Freed-Hardeman. And now we tied it back up here 4-4.
Sorry about that, Mike. I'll leave you hanging. I had to take that call. It's a it's a company we order medicine from at the doctor's office, and she was calling to tell me good news. And I had to get what she wanted to tell me I have to have because we have people needing that. And I'm not going to talk about what medicine it is. That's not for this. But just I stepped away, and you let them come back and tie it 4-4, though.
Hey, that just
they actually must have taken a 4-3 lead or something.
They did take a 4-3 lead, but that's why you're the good luck charm around here.
We like to think that, don't we? And there's a service ace, Ashlyn Clift. Tell you what,
and as soon as you come back, they go on a 3-0 run.
Sorry. I don't know what to tell you.
Well, you got the good luck in softball and now volleyball.
Nice. Going to come out to Dunnigan. Tell you what, if you don't get a hand on the ball, nine times out of ten, she hits so powerful, she's going to put that down.
She's going to be competing with the baseball team, see who can
who's got the fastest fastball. That's it. The speed. And it's going to be out because it was on the came on the backside of the antenna. Tell you what, we've got some strong players. I'm very interested in seeing where we have grown as we go into conference play again in the Mid-South Conference.
And I believe the first game is against Pikeville this upcoming week, I believe.
Yeah, hang on, I tell you.
And that'll be Friday.
Yeah, we play Pikeville comes into town on Friday. That starts at 7 o'clock. And then we're back in here Saturday afternoon at 3 as – Cumberland University out of
I believe that's the one in Kentucky right there. That is the Cumberlands.
So, yes, the Patriots, they're out of Williamsburg, Kentucky. In our conference, we need to make sure we got a Cumberland University and a University of the Cumberlands. Of course, Cumberland is in Lebanon, Tennessee, right?
That's right.
And there's another service ace. I tell you what, Freed-Hardeman has gone on a 7 or 8. It was 5-3?
No, it was 4. So they Crowley's Ridge has scored 1 because it was 4.
Okay, it was 4.
When you did come back.
Okay, so, well. Morris with the up. Humphrey with the set. Walker. You see how she read that block and she saw it? So she just – the idea is to get it over to – you know on paper what that looks like?
I believe
that looks like the hardest smash that she could ever hit. It's that same result.
That's right. And, of course, using that 5 years experience now that she has here at Freed-Hardeman.
And Crowley's Ridge takes a timeout at 13-5. We're going to take a 30-second timeout. We'll be right back with more on the FHU Sports Network.
This could be a true story. On October 3rd, a 2003 hatchback struck and killed a deer that goes by the name Buck. I know, right? He now has Buck's head proudly displayed on his living room wall. He tells a different story.
Shot it.
No, he didn't.
And to hide his lie, he took his car to Mitchell's Body Shop.
No, I didn't.
Yes, he did. Oh. And lucky for him, they made it look good as new. And as for Buck, the story continues.
And welcome back in. For those of you that are in the Henderson area,
I believe you can see
that's Coach Humphrey's son, Jared, over there that we're seeing. But, hey, we appreciate all the folks who have stepped up to sponsor Freed-Hardeman Sports. And always looking for more, you can contact Paul Schultze at Worthy Roads Studio, and he can get you information on advertising packages. There's a little dump over. Humphrey comes to Walker. Yeah, tip. Yep.
I believe that did.
Yep. I'm going to try to get Paul to get us a camera that'll be right there on the top of the net. That way we can see all that stuff. And there you go. There's Annalise Jackson again. The only problem is cameras aren't cheap.
One
ball hitting a camera down there would not be a good thing.
I don't believe you can find any camera nowadays, whether you're just taking regular pictures or anything. That'll be good advice if you take intro to photography here at Freed-Hardeman.
Yeah, Olivia Deckelman with the little roll shot. Morris couldn't get to it, so it's 15-6. That's a tough serve to read as it hit the top of the net. Oh, nice
and
job.
Just
there.
Got it in.
That was nice. And the kill there for number 6, Hannah, say Halverson, I believe it is.
I believe it is Hannah Halverson or Halverson or we'll try to get a pronunciation.
We'll get that right. There's the set. There she is again. She's doing that little just kind of touch shot over. Walker back deep to the libero, digs it up. Morris on nice dig out of the net by Humphrey. And you're going to get a net violation. It looks like it's going to be on number 10, Paige Glenn, the middle blocker from Paragould, Arkansas.
And I believe she's one of three or four players that are from Paragould.
Yeah, they get a lot of players from Paragould.
Of course, I believe Paragould is one of them towns that you have probably about three or four high schools, kind of like Jackson.
Yeah. She went to Paragould High School. Then you had the other one went to Greene County High School.
And that's Halverson right there. And then you have Elms, who went to Crowley's Ridge Academy.
Yep. Of course, now, you know, they got freshmen. They've got one senior, two seniors. I don't see any juniors on there.
No juniors, I believe. And, of course, Freed-Hardeman, I believe they've got a –
I think we've got three seniors. Yeah, we have three seniors.
Confirm that here in just a minute. I forgot you got your roster over there as well.
And there's four juniors. Maybe five if I miscounted. And Walker is going to set up a back row. Humphrey digs it up. Fulton with the set. Watching the action here. And Walker with the kill. In that first set, we mentioned Freed-Hardeman hit 321. 14 kills on 28 total attacks. That's a pretty good. And there's a kill there by Glenn for Crowley's Ridge. I was trying to look at the defense. Yeah, Freed-Hardeman in the first set had 20 digs. That's nice. Yeah, Crowley's Ridge is figured. Freed-Hardeman's got a little bit of height up there on the front row, and so Crowley's Ridge is Crowley's Ridge. Crowley's. I'll get that right, folks. Crowley's Ridge. And Walker with another kill. So this set, it's Claire Walker doing the work for Freed-Hardeman. That's why I say you've got a dynamic duo of killers, of attackers.
And Freed-Hardeman, they, of course, returning a lot of the players they had last year as well. And that's going to help them a lot.
You know, and I'm sure that we're going to see as we get into playing more schools, especially at conference, we're going to see a lot of fifth-year players. Is that time Emmy Elms gets the kill. It's 2012, though. All the pressure on Crowley's Ridge. Speaks, dig. And going to be a free ball for Freed-Hardeman. Tell you what, I have to say I'm impressed with Avery Harris. She had two kills, or she only had one kill in the last, but I think she's got at least two or three here in set number two. We'll find out when Jeremy Wright, who came back. Yeah, he graduated last year with his bachelor's. He came back working on his master's degree. He's working as Taylor Hodges' assistant in sports information. He said he's working with Tony Allen in intramurals.
I believe so. I believe that he was telling me about that the other day. He is excited for that. Of course, intramurals, big part of Freed-Hardeman's campus. Added two more sports to the intramurals seasons, so that'll be very interesting.
What all did they add this time?
They added Ultimate Frisbee. I believe that'll be maybe a fall sport, and then dodgeball will be in the spring.
Oh, dodgeball.
Of course, basketball and football, softball, and volleyball. That was all sports that were here last year.
Yeah, when I was in school, you had ping pong as an intramural sport. You didn't want to play my wife. You had spades and rook as intramural sports.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, we had some good stuff back way back when. As Freed-Hardeman now 23-13.
I believe at one time they had golf, didn't they?
Which,
of course, that might be a story.
I don't know that they had. They didn't have it when I was here. We had tackle football when I was here as an intramural. It ended, I think it was my sophomore year. There's the over. Humphrey with the up. Speaks to Dunnigan. Dunnigan gets a kill. Let's see here. When Jeremy brings that stat sheet up here, let us see the evenness of the kills in set number two.
It's been a
balanced. As from the back row, Humphrey now sets to the middle, and you're going to get two hits on Humphrey. That's a good call.
And you say Bryce Moore is going to come in there for Ashlyn Clift.
Because you got to remember, now I've watched Allie and Bryce, and, of course, you got Tori Trice is also for Chester County, a freshman. She's the line judge on the far corner. But I saw all those kids grow up. Ashlyn, Ivy. We have not seen Ivy Robinson as of yet. A nice block back. Humphrey going to go up, going to go to the middle. And Annalise Jackson puts it away. That's going to give Freed-Hardeman a win in set number two. We're going to take a break. We'll be back after these messages on the FHU Sports Network.
Buying a car is all about you. In person, over the phone, or online, we make it simple and easy. Our place is yours, no matter where you live. LonnieCobbFord.com or Lonnie Cobb Ford in Henderson, where cars really are cheaper in the country. At Lonnie Cobb Ford, we now give you a warranty for life on engine and transmission. That's right, a warranty for life at no cost to you. Unlimited time, unlimited mileage, but it's only at Lonnie Cobb Ford in Henderson, where cars really are cheaper in the country.
With extra pandemic unemployment funding coming to an end in Tennessee, you should not hesitate to find a job that pays what you need and treats you well, because those jobs are going to go as quickly as gasoline in a shortage. Apply today at McLean Power Systems in Trenton. This is what their workers had to say.
I like the atmosphere of the department I work in the warehouse, and I like my leadership team with the manager and supervisor.
I actually like that you are able to grow within the company. I started here as an operator in the sales, and I've been able to work my way up to a supervisor.
Honestly, it's every person I've kind of interacted with here. I've enjoyed every one of them.
I've been with McLean almost 2 years now, and I will have to say, not only with the great pay and benefits, leadership is absolutely wonderful.
Make your next career move to McLean today by texting POWER to 67664. That's POWER to 67664. McLean Power Systems is an equal opportunity employer.
Football looks fun. I bet I would have been great at it. The first football playing deer, they would have made a movie about me and everything. Probably get Kurt Russell to play me. But alas, me and my dreams run right over again.
For fast, reliable collision repair, trust the experts at Mitchell's Body Shop. And get back out there.
And welcome back in. Ray Pack and Michael Mullenix bringing you Freed-Hardeman volleyball today. Remind you, we'll be back Saturday at game time, 3 o'clock, as University of the Cumberlands comes to town with that broadcast. There will be a game here Friday night at 7, and it will be streamed, but there will be no audio. It'll be a production of Freed-Hardeman University. Today's broadcast is a production of Worthy Road Studios. I guess I better remind everybody, Michael, after this match, we will have
Crowley's Ridge taking on Lane College. And then after that match, Freed-Hardeman will play their second match as they will take on the Dragons of Lane College. All right, let's look. All right, now remember, this is going to be the total of both sets. So Freed-Hardeman still hitting at a 397 clip. That's a very good percentage.
Ooh, nice save there by, well,
it was a nice play.
It was a nice play there. I believe that might have been Gabby Rodriguez, if I'm not mistaken.
All right, so in set number two, Annalise Jackson, she had four kills. Avery Harris had two kills. Ashlyn Cliff had one. Claire Walker had six. And Casey Donegan had two. So kind of pretty even right here as Crowley's Ridge takes up 2-0. And there's an overpass to the setter, so Freed-Hardeman gets the break there. As we have on the floor for Freed-Hardeman, new player number 17, I believe that's Gabby Rodriguez, sophomore from San Antonio, Texas.
That's right, and also Annalise Jackson just checked in for the libero, Emma Campbell.
Yeah, Jackson up there on the front row. Now your libero comes in for Avery Harris. You know, libero can go in for any player at any time, but if she's going to serve, she has to serve in the same position each time. This time she's going to set Dunnigan. Dunnigan kind of bumps it over. Back set, that's number 16, Kaylee Klein. Freshman, I'm going to count here. One, two, six freshmen on the team for Crowley's Ridge. Served by Clift.
And I believe also with these freshmen from Crowley's Ridge, two of them from right here in the state of Tennessee.
Yeah, one. I noticed you've got one from Millington, number one, Emma Spate.
And then you have Alexis Wyrich, I hope I'm saying that right.
I think it's Wyrich, if I remember correctly.
She's from McNary Central, just right down south of us.
So the beauty is of this, I get to watch these high school kids from the area doing Chester County High School sports. So it's always good to see them make it off.
And you get to do the same thing, I know, with basketball this year, especially on the boys' side. You got Dalton Colbert from right here in Henderson. And then you also got – I know we had one come in from Bolivar this year.
You got one? I have looked at the roster. You got Dalton Colbert from right here in Henderson. You got a player from Bolivar. You've got a kid that went to Fayette Ware. Now, he went to prep school last year, but he is here. So there's three local area – players there. And Annalise Jackson, I tell you what, Freed-Hardeman is actually, they're picking it up now.
And of course, like I said, if Freed-Hardeman wins this one, they win the game, and that'd be a good thing to put this team out 3-0, and that way you can play even harder against Lane College later tonight at 7.
That's a good point. You get a little bit of refresh. It gives you time to get your legs refreshed. But the thing with Lane, you got to remember, they're going to be playing back-to-back.
That is true.
Crowley's Ridge is going to play back-to-back. And, you know, Freed-Hardeman gets the break. I guess that's the part of a tri-match that you like is being the home team. You space your matches apart.
And you see that done a lot here with a lot of these high school, I guess what you call play days and stuff.
Yeah.
I know I repped a summer league this year from my hometown. I believe it was Lewis County, and then you had Summertown and then Perry County, and Lewis County had the –
But Coach Humphrey has a play day here every year. I can't remember how many teams he had this year in play day, but they come in and they'll play five or six matches in one day. as Humphrey mishits the ball. So 7-4.
And, of course, like we said, here in the next week, next 7 days, actually, Freed-Hardeman's got three straight conference games, Pikeville, Cumberland's, and University or Cumberland University.
Now, you got Pikeville, University of the Cumberlands, and then Cumberland comes to town. So it'll be a busy little bit of time. Volleyball starting to pick up.
And we might try to get some information on those three teams later against Lane, kind of give an insight.
In between this game and Freed's last game, we may try to look, see what we can find. That time, nobody out where the set was. And there's a set to the middle hitter for Crowley's Ridge. And now to the outside hitter, nice up there by Campbell. And Gabby Rodriguez tries to avoid the net but goes into it. Coach Humphrey playing quite a few younger players here in this set. Rodriguez played a little bit of varsity last year, but trying to get a little bit of experience here. Need a little depth as you get into conference play.
That's right. And, of course, last year, from what we saw, Rodriguez and Jackson, probably the only two that we really got to see on the floor half of the time.
Let's see. We got to see last year. We haven't seen her yet today, but Ariana Wells from Middleton. We hadn't seen her yet today. We haven't seen Ivy Robinson. Of course, Ivy was hurt last year, so she's still coming back slowly.
That's right. And not sure how much she got to play over down in Alabama this past week and stuff either.
Tell you what, Gabby Rodriguez with the power smash right there. And it's 10-6. The block. There's a block back. Humphrey and Harris. And there's an overpass. Rodriguez to Humphrey. Back set. Harris. Kill. Oh, that play that just happened prior to the kill, where Harris, they went up for the block, her and Rodriguez blocked it, and then you noticed Harris was able to bump it back up. So that's a very nice play right there. And you're going to get a double block right there from Humphrey and Harris.
And the height on Freed-Hardeman, the Lady Lions right now, is just something you're not even really used to seeing nowadays in the NAIA.
Yeah, you got 5'10", 5'10". So you've got quite a bit of height out there for Freed. Nice save by Fulton. Rodriguez with the over.
And nice effort by Fulton. Just couldn't come up with it.
That time Passmore was able to just kind of take her hand and throw it over. Oh, nice pancake right there. Harris thought she had the kill. They're going to come out to Rodriguez. Rodriguez puts it down.
Rodriguez backing Harris up right there. Says, I'll help you out right there.
Yeah. Like a lot, you like to see that, though. 13-7, set three, best three of five. And Humphrey with the back set to Ashlyn Cliff. And Humphrey the setter out. Campbell gets Rodriguez. Rodriguez crossed there to the libero for Crowley's Ridge. And there's another. I tell you what, they've done that twice now. And Rodriguez with the cross. Now deep shot by Crowley's Ridge. Now Rodriguez again, and that time off the fingertips at the net, and it falls down.
Now, I mean, that was good hustle by Crowley's Ridge. You got to give him credit on that, but Freed-Hardeman just able to capitalize on tiring Crowley's Ridge out right there.
Yeah, that time the hands not –
Turn the right direction, and the ball carries out of bounds for a point for Crowley's Ridge. There's another kill in the middle for Harris.
Good setup right there as well.
So it looks like Rodriguez is in for Claire Walker. Rodriguez with the serve, her first serve of the day. And going to get Casey Donegan in the net. Pass more serving. Rodriguez. Now Campbell to Donegan. Blocked right back. Nice job by Freed-Hardeman getting it back over. Humphrey out. Campbell. Donegan with just a little roll. That shows up in the stat sheet just as well as a power smash. Harris serving. Perkins, the libero, dug that up at reception. Put it up, and that ball goes off the hands of Allie Humphrey. Yeah, you look across the way, you see the Dragons of Lane rolling in, and there is a long serve by Emmy Elms, goes out of bounds. So Freed-Hardeman in control here, 17-10.
And that one just out right there. Good effort there by Crowley's Ridge to go over the height on the front row there of Freed-Hardeman, but just unfortunately not enough room to work with. And that time they did get enough room to work with, just snuck it in right there, Coach.
Yeah, I like that. So 18-11 on the floor for Freed-Hardeman. You got 14, Allie Humphrey, 31, Casey Donegan, 17, Gabby Rodriguez, 24, Emma Campbell. There's Bryce Morris, number 11. And in number 5, as Donegan left it short.
Tried to shorthand it a little bit.
And Annalise Jackson's number 5. I lost my train of thought there. My wife's trying to make sure I get something to eat. And Donegan, now that's a power hit right there.
Yeah. When it hits off of the hands of the opposite team and about goes up here in the second deck up here.
Well, that's off the hands of the defender, almost it does go up into the walking track. So 20-12, Freed-Hardeman 5 points away from a win in match number 1. We see how that ball stayed up on the net like that time. Nice hit there by Jackson. Here's another one. Tell you what, that's 2 or 3 in a row we've seen it stay up on. Rodriguez. Now Crowley's Ridge with the attack. Oh, nice dump by Humphrey. Crowley's Ridge expecting that. And Rodriguez, just a little dink. Yeah, we just playing a little dink ball now. There we go. Annalise Jackson powers it, comes back over. Humphrey, Rodriguez, cross court. Nice kill.
That's probably one of the longest possessions I've
that may be the longest rally of the day.
And now we're getting another sub here. That's going to be number 18.
Yeah, Humphrey's coming out, and that's going to bring in.
That's Adley Mays, the freshman out of Dothan, Alabama. I believe it's how you pronounce it.
You are correct.
And Mays is trying to look at her position right here. Kind of got off track right here. And, of course, Donegan with a serve. And good read on it by Campbell going out of bounds. And now, just like that, Freed-Hardeman 2 points away from not only winning the set but winning the game. And Donegan back on the serve. And Crowley's Ridge unable to come up with it. And now one point away.
So you're at match point. As we see a few more people filtering in. And there's the serve. Nice serve. That's a hard one to handle. And that's going to do it. So Freed-Hardeman is going to move to 2-3 overall after a 3-0 win over the Pioneers of Crowley's Ridge. We're going to have Coach Humphrey, not after this match, but he's going to come up and visit with us after match number 2. So, Michael, we'll wait for some stats, but let's let Paul get a couple of commercials in. We'll take about a 2-minute break right here, and we'll be back to wrap this one up in just a moment on the FHU Sports Network.
Men, there's a new salon in Jackson, Race Clips, on South Highland, next door to Roland Safety and Supply. Whether it's a quick trim or a new look, Race Clips stylists can transform you to perfection. At Race Clips, you'll find all the products to keep you looking your best. Active duty military, veterans, and law enforcement officers receive a discount. Open Monday through Friday from 9 to 6, 9 to 3 on Saturday. Race Clips on South Highland, Jackson. Go to race-clips.com.
27 years ago, a vision became a reality and Snookum Steakhouse officially opened. We cut our steaks in-house and our ribeyes are full of flavor. The steak trimmings are used to make our certified Angus beef steak burgers, so when you order at Snookum's, you are getting high quality. Enjoy our salad bar and mini dessert. Also try our famous family recipe, the Pink Lush Fruit Salad. Come visit Snookum Steakhouse in Henderson, Tennessee. We are open evenings Tuesday through Saturday, but closed Sunday and Monday. Snookum Steakhouse, come taste the difference.
This could be a true story. On October 3rd, a 2003 hatchback struck and killed a deer that goes by the name Buck. I know, right? He now has Buck's head proudly displayed on his living room wall. He tells a different story.
Shot it.
No, he didn't.
And to hide his lie, he took his car to Mitchell's body shop.
No, I didn't.
Yes, he did. And lucky for him, they made it look good as new. And as for Buck, the story continues.
Buying a car is all about you. In person, over the phone, or online, we make it simple and easy. Our place is yours, no matter where you live. LonnieCobbFord.com or Lonnie Cobb Ford in Henderson, where cars really are cheaper in the country. At Lonnie Cobb Ford, we now give you a warranty for life on engine and transmission. That's right, a warranty for life at no cost to you. Unlimited time, unlimited mileage, but it's only at Lonnie Cobb Ford in Henderson, where cars really are cheaper in the country.
All right, welcome back in. Joined with Coach Humphrey after a 3-0 win over the Pioneers of Crowley's Ridge. Coach, kind of for me, it was kind of hard to get a whole lot. I don't know, you got some stuff out of it. I thought our attacking was pretty good, pretty balanced attack between really three players. I was really impressed with Avery Harris.
Yeah, well, you know, we were able to get some things. Kind of, we knew we could do some things serving and serve receive. We worked on that a lot yesterday. We feel like we're a little bit a quicker team this year offensively with Avery. And, of course, everybody else is back from last year. you know, Allie set last year. She's running a 5-1 this year and allows us to be a little bit quicker than we were a little bit last year. We came out from the first whistle and we didn't let up. And that's what we talked about in the huddle there at the end, that we played a complete game.
And you have to worry sometimes about when you have an easier time, do you keep that focus in through all three, which I know the third set, it was what, 4-4, and then we go on a big run and close it out.
Right, and I wanted to, you know, I put some of our freshmen in there to get them some playing time, and you want to do that, but you also, there's a fine line. You don't want to mess up your chemistry. You know, you're playing well and everybody's moving, especially we just got back from the Faulkner tournament, you know, a week or so ago, and we felt like we left on that Saturday feeling pretty good about that Saturday morning game and the Saturday afternoon game. We felt like we had a little bit of a rhythm going. Of course, Labor Day weekend kind of threw us off a little bit, but then we come in today and had a good rhythm. So doing a lot of subs, even though you want to get your kids some playing time and some court time, you don't want to mess up that rhythm, that routine. So, that, you know, it's kind of a fine line there.
Right. Well, you took on one of your former players, Carissa Wynn, graduated in 2011.
Yeah, love Carissa.
And she's doing a great job over there with this team. I mean, you look at it, she's got two seniors, I think, is what Michael and I counted. Yeah. So she's young.
Yeah. You know, Carissa took that program over, I guess, two or three years ago.
2 or 3 years ago, that's
right. And I knew when she got that job that she would do a good job because I knew what kind of player she was when she was here. She's a very fundamentally sound player when she played ball here. She knows how to be the fine line of being the coach and the player. You know, she can tell them what she did, but she can also tell them what she wants out of them. And I think in years to come, they will be, you know, they'll be a lot better for it, for the hire of Carissa. So.
Now, are they moving? Are they still playing as an independent this year, or are they moving into our old conference, the American Midwest, or do you know where that's at?
They are still as an independent, but they've changed the name of the AII to some kind of other conference name. I'm not sure exactly what it is. I'm no longer a Raider, so I don't get all that information as far as the conference information, but I want to say it's something like Continental or something like that. I don't know. But we talked a little bit about it before the game. Of course, I had to go talk to her because catch up on things and how things are going over in Arkansas and her family. And I saw her mom and dad are here, and her mom and dad very, very, very rarely miss anything that she does. So they've been coming. They know the road between here and Paragould very well.
Very well.
Yeah.
What's about, what, two and a half, 3 hours, or a little bit further?
Well, depending on who's driving. But, yeah, probably about two and a half, yeah. So,
well, I guess if you and I are driving, it's going to take probably closer to two. Is that what you're saying?
I'm just saying I like Arkansas roads is what I'm saying. So I guess when you live, born and raised in Arkansas, you know all the little nooks and crannies over there. So, you know, but you get behind a tractor, a combine or something like that, you might as well just kind of camp
out. Bide your time and camp out. You're right.
Yeah. But I thought for us to play an opening game here, we always want to play Crowley's Ridge just because of who they are, the school that they are, the sister school, with the relationship that we have. I've had several players from Crowley's Ridge Academy over here play ball for me, Rachel and Emily and Carissa, of course, and then Maddie Harden played last year with us, and she's down there keeping score for us. And then we know that school very well.
Well, and I think it's a good thing to be playing them every year. I mean, we were playing them back when they were just a 2-year school. So
yeah.
Experience.
When I first got the job here in 2000, we played over there. We even practiced when we went to play Lion, and we went back. We were able to use their gym for practice sometimes. So we've had a good relationship over the years. And so.
But talk about your freshmen you had incoming. Tell me a little bit about each of those freshmen you have.
Well, I think you recognize Charlie Fulton. Charlie Fulton played back row today for Casey. That's Riley's sister. A very fundamentally sound player. I think Charlie would be in there more often if we didn't have everybody returning this year from last year's team. I'm not saying she's not good enough, but it's hard to take a starter from last year out of the rotation unless, you know, we do that. And so – I don't guess I get one. Do I get one?
Yeah, I got. He brought two. So you,
good deal.
Yeah, it's first time you've seen them, though. But you pretty well know what we did. But
I feel pretty good, like you said, as a balanced attack. But back to the freshmen. I think Charlie, I've talked to her a little bit. We talked about her role a little bit, and she's going to hold down that middle back defense. That's where she played with back-to-back state championships there at Nolensville. Avery coming in from Lebanon, playing front row for us in the middle. Real quick player, you know, and does a nice job for us. Adley, I put Adley in there to set with, opposite of Allie, or for Allie, and we won the next four points, whatever. And so I got to get her in there a little bit sooner next time. And Adley is from Alabama. She said it's about a 6-hour drive, and I'm like, wow, that's a journey.
Yeah, that's all the way down there by Gulf Shores.
She says she's
pretty close to the Gulf Shores.
On the bottom. And then, you know, I got Gabrielle in there at the end as well for Claire. Gabrielle is an all-around player. She plays front row really well. My thoughts are for her in the future would be something more like a libero. I think she's a very talented back row player. She's very quick. And the fact that she reads the ball really well. So, I like her a lot in the back row, in a libero setting or DS setting. So I think that's what the future holds for her. She's just a sophomore, and she came in last year during the COVID year. So
she had a couple of really nice hits today.
She did.
A little bit of power.
Well, you know, she filled in last year for us when we had a lot of injuries in the middle. We moved Ashlyn over to the middle from the right side, and we moved Gabrielle to the right side, and she did fine. She did really well. She can play any position. I think she could even set if she needed to. But we got to find what's best for her. What best position?
That generally takes you a year or so. Do that.
And you hate to say you out recruit yourself, but we got a lot of talented girls over here on the sideline. And you know, Claire Walker come back for her COVID year, and Jaden Watkins is out with an injury right now. But Jaden is a very, very strong pin hitter, and I think when you see her, you're really, really going to like her. She's a power hitter on the outside. So, you know, we got more depth than we've had in a long time, Ray.
But, I mean, I know Ivy didn't get to play today. She's played in some matches down at Faulkner.
Yeah.
Is she still Ivy a ginger with her injury? Or?
Ivy is still learning what she can do with her shoulder.
Okay.
She started out a little bit down there, and she's still a little bit hesitant. That scares her a little bit. I feel like she will be back in there at some point. I've told her that. She's frustrated. I know that. But we want to get her back in there. She's a good – to me, she's better a better defensive blocker or defensive middle than she is offensive right now, because she reads the hit really well. But right now she's nursing that shoulder, and she's trying to come back off that rehab year and surgery. So,
well, we look forward to her getting back out there.
Yes.
Let's look at this stat sheet real quick. I mentioned balance, and I was pretty close. Annalise with 10 kills, mm-hmm. Claire with 9, Casey with 12. Congratulations to her for hitting that 1,000 mark.
Uh-huh.
So that's a pretty balance between really. That I'm assuming those are going to be your three big hitters.
I think so. I think we'll get more out of Cliff on the right side, running a 5-1 this year. I think we'll get more out of her. And then I think, you know, this is only the second match for Avery to come in, and she had 5 kills today, hitting 400, you know. So I feel like once we get more accustomed to, like I said, this is already the year, and people, you know, we want to make some – we don't need to make decisions right now. We're still kind of doing that feeling out.
Well, you're pre-conference. You know, conference starts, what, Thursday night or Friday night, your first conference,
Friday
night.
Friday night, yes, sir. Yes, sir. So we have Pikeville and University of Cumberland coming to town this weekend. So it'll be a busy weekend, and softball's on the road to Dyersburg this weekend. So it'll be a busy weekend.
Are you going to be getting to go to any of the Dyersburg, or
no,
is Caitlin going to take care of all that?
Caitlin will be coaching team 2, and Jared will be coaching team 1.
So he's going to come back and help you this year again?
No, he's just filling
or
in.
Or he's just filling in for you in. While
yeah,
you're
– He's still okay. coaching out at Chester County, doing a great job out there, but he's still able to help us out here. And the reason why he's coaching Team 1 is because he's coached these girls before, and he knows what these girls are doing, and Kaden will take the freshmen.
I'm looking forward to softball season as well. But, you know, we get through volleyball first.
Yeah, one thing at a time.
You do one at a time.
One thing at a time. My wife and daughter were here. They're on their way to Hardin County.
I knew they had a match in Hardin County tonight, yeah. They left right at the end of the third set.
Yeah, she said she was going to come till at least 3:45, and then she's going to have to head out to get over there in time for the 5 o'clock match. So,
is it at home or is
no,
it?
No,
it's at
Hardin
it's
County.
At Hardin County.
Yeah.
So
she'll get there about 4:30, and they'll give them a 30-minute warm up, and they'll play JV at 5 and varsity at 6. And I don't know. We haven't played Hardin County this year. I don't.
No, we. So. This will be the first one, and we close it. It's generally the same as it is every year. We've closed out the season. It was senior night at Chester County. It's normally against Hardin County.
Right, right. So, you know, they're the West Tennessee High School volleyball is picking up a little bit. You know, Lexington has a strong program. Crockett County still strong this year. I tell you who else is strong is Dyersburg and Dyer County. That's a hotbed over there in that little area.
Right.
Dyersburg
northwest
and Dyer
corner.
County. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So you got to watch those people over there. So, you know, Chester County's right there. I'm not sure what the record is. We don't talk about
we don't,
that.
I don't know that Susie really worries about her record. She just worries about going match to match.
I know she's going to McEwen this weekend for a tournament, and I heard her talk on the phone. She said she didn't care who she played. The coach called her and, you know, had that flood up there, and they're trying to rearrange everything with the schedule because of that flood. And so she said, I heard on the phone, she said, I don't care who we play. We just want to play. And so that's kind of – she's looking forward to the end of the season.
Well, what – I was going to say, I know she likes to win. She's very competitive. Don't get me wrong.
No doubt.
But she's not worried about regular season. She's building towards
tournament.
You know, district tournament.
Yeah.
And it doesn't matter what seed she is in the district, because she feels she's going to be good enough to beat anybody at that time of year.
That's the key. Get your team prepared. Get your team prepared for tournament and see what falls. And that's what she's doing right now. So.
I mentioned I know they had a match game scheduled with Sacred Heart, former player here. Shay Dean is working with Sacred Heart.
Watch out for Shay Dean. The Sacred Heart and them are doing a good job.
I was going to say. It hurt.
And so Shay's doing a really nice job with them, and she got some talent there. And, you know, it makes me proud when I see Carissa and Shay and some of them who are now coaching. J.C. Campbell, if you remember her from a couple years ago.
I do.
She's coaching down in Arkansas, Southwest Arkansas.
Now, is McKenzie working with Jackson Christian?
McKenzie is starting a program at Jackson Christian. They will start playing in the spring. She's excited about that because she gets to start from scratch. So we've got some players who've gone out, and Emily Hicks is working over at USJ. Martha Sheffield, was Martha Ray at the time, is coaching over at USJ. So we've got some former players all over the place, and I'll leave somebody out because I always do.
I'll just throw this at, that's a testament to your mentorship and what you were able to accomplish with them while they were here that prepared them for that.
I hope so.
I honestly believe that.
Well, you know, Amanda's doing a great job here with us. Happy to get Amanda
back. She went
back
to Hardin County and coached for 2 years. So.
And I think that was good. You know, I would love to have hired my son, Jared, to come here and work with me when we were looking at the process of hiring coaches. But, you know, a coach needs to step out on their own. And I told Jared that. I said, you need to get out and get your own team for a while and coach on, you know, get away from dad and do your own thing, because that's where you start learning. And then if it happens down the road from now, we hook back up down the road. If I'm an athletic director somewhere and I were to be able to hire him or something, then so be it. But right now, he needs to kind of get out and get his own feet wet away from mom and dad. So,
all right. Well, Coach, we're going to talk to you after the second game, too. All right. And you bring Casey or bring a player or two up with you.
I will.
We'll talk to them.
I will.
We're about 46 minutes away from Crowley's Ridge and Lane going at it. And, again, that will be streamed. There'll be no audio commentary, but we're going to keep the stream going and show that for fans there. And then we'll come back. Oh, it's going to be a new stream. So where will they need to go, Paul, to find that? Will it be available on the FHU portal?
I think that's where you would probably look. I think Taylor probably has it all on the portal for Freed-Hardeman.
So we'll kill this one, and then we'll come back with another one. But we are going to bring you that same match.
Make sure you mention if they want to help out with the broadcasting of this, that make sure they know who to get in touch with.
I've already mentioned three times if they want to help sponsor that they can get a hold of Paul. I assume I could mention his name, can I not, Paul?
You can get in touch with me.
You or Dan Hughes, one of the three of you,
and
you can give them all the information
you
need.
This is such a nice luxury that we have at Freed-Hardeman, that we can broadcast our games and have commentary. And it's not just volleyball. It's a lot of sports. I think we're going to try to do basketball, baseball, softball. I don't know about soccer, but if we do soccer, we're not doing soccer.
I'm not going to do soccer.
I saw his head shaking over here.
No soccer.
There's
no,
hard
no,
to do.
No money to do soccer. Plus, have you ever had to try to do play-by-play on soccer?
Right. I've coached soccer.
Okay.
I've coached soccer.
I've never been around soccer that much, so I don't know that I would know
enough about it. If there was one more sport that I could coach at Freed-Hardeman, it would be soccer. I love soccer.
How about if I put your name in the hat?
No.
Okay.
I'm doing my two right now, and then we'll see where that goes. Okay?
All right, Todd. Appreciate you, man. We'll holler at you after the next game.
Sounds good.
So we're going to cut away. I'm Ray Pack. We're on the Worthy Road Studio Network. Stay tuned. Up next will be Crowley's Ridge and Lane College right here from the Brewer Sports Center and Smith Kirk Court. We'll be back. Thanks for tuning in.